I am back in Michigan today, now in the town of Glen Arbor at the Clarity Guesthouse Airbnb. This spot feels like a boutique hotel to me. There are 24-foot tall ceilings inside. That may be a new record. I also loved all of the furnishings and location, location, location. We are literally a 2-minute drive to Lake Michigan. My first time seeing any of the Great Lakes here in the US, and I've gotta say, it's pretty epic. So you guys are gonna love this place. Let's now go and start the tour. Welcome to the Clarity Guesthouse in Glen Arbor, Michigan. This is a modern chalet with 3 bedrooms and 3 baths, and we are gonna go on a full tour today. There is a bright blue exterior, which cannot be missed when you first drive up. There's a bit of weather throughout my stay, but that didn't stop me. So let's walk on over here to check out some of the outdoor amenities. First up, you have this large fire pit with 4 chairs around it. I still somehow managed to start a fire despite the half snow and half rainstorm going on here, but hey, every great cabin needs a nice fire pit. Now, further down, you have these long lines of string lights, and I'll take this cover off to reveal your hot tub. You can easily fit a bunch of guests inside, and this is very much needed, I think, during the colder Michigan weather. I was visiting in late March, and it was still pretty chilly out. Last but not least, for the exterior, like I mentioned earlier, right down the road from the cabin, you have access to Lake Michigan and this pretty sizable beach that stretches on for a while. I even did a polar plunge, or I actually went in the water, which I definitely do not suggest doing this time of the year. It was really cold, and I flew my drone up high in the clouds to get this gorgeous drone shot. I love the different colors of the water. That's it for the exterior and location, so let's open up this door and go inside. We'll look to the left first, where you have these 2 doors. We'll enter the door on the right, and this leads into the first full bathroom. It's very white and clean and has everything that you need. We'll now continue down that same hallway and enter the door on the left. This will take you into the first of 3 bedrooms. You have a simple black and white color scheme here, 2 of some of my favorite colors, so I enjoyed it. And you have a luggage rack, a circular mirror, and this nice desk and work from home setup in the corner, which includes some images from Italy, I believe. Now, directly across from that first entrance door that we used, you have this long staircase which leads up to the 2nd floor. We'll first go into this other bathroom. It's pretty similar to the one that we saw downstairs, but the main difference is this beautiful shower that we see now at the far end, made up of this simple black and white tiles, but they're pretty small and intricate. I can only imagine how much time it took to lay all this tiling down. Let's now head into the bedroom. I believe this is the kiddies room with the 2 queen-size mattresses. It continues with the color scheme, just with a hint of blue. I also love the flooring. It's very slick, almost shiny looking, and has the 2 contrasting colors. The Airbnb owner also served in the Navy, so the room is pretty nautical or ship themed throughout. If I now take the camera and pan more to the right, there's a bunch of stuff along that other wall, including some more luggage racks and decorations on the far right hand side, but also this really cool looking mirror there that felt almost like something out of Harry Potter. I don't really know what I'm doing here. I'm probably making fun of the fact that I wear the same outfit and hat in like 90% of my YouTube videos, but anyways, let's now go back downstairs to check out the main room. I'm walking past that first entrance door, and now welcome to the main room. I'll start first with an overview. Looking out this way, you have your living room and a bunch of giant windows, and now this is your modern and very well-equipped kitchen. I'll come first into the living room though, and I'll turn on the gas fireplace very easily with the flick of a switch. I'm definitely starting to lean more towards gas fireplaces lately. Just the pure convenience is great, and this one spit out a lot of heat. Now, a bunch of these next few shots were all taken on my drone, because yes, you have your 24-foot tall ceilings, which I'm trying my best to demonstrate here, but just you have to go in person because this room is absolutely massive. You take the camera now and pan up, you can see just how long it takes the camera to get towards the ceiling. You have a lot of space here. In this far corner too, you can see that the fireplace runs up this entire wall. This room is very, very impressive. In terms of the layout now, on the far left, there's another door which leads back outside, and the dining table is directly beneath us now with the drone. But now I'll focus more on the living room. I have my morning cup of tea, and I just started my day out here next to the fire on my next day of shooting. You have these two comfortable white chairs though, your smart TV, and this gorgeous looking couch. This is just the definition of cozy cabin vibes, in my opinion. We'll now switch gears to the kitchen. First up, you have this absolutely gigantic kitchen island in the middle. There are also three lighting fixtures up top, and then four black stools beneath the island. If you go behind the counter now, you have a slew of high-end appliances, like your fridge and freezer there on the left. You then have a beautiful backsplash there on the far wall and more countertop space, including your oven and stovetop. Hidden in these cabinets, you then have even more appliances, some of your plates and bowls, your microwave, and then a bunch of mugs and wine glasses can be found here up top. Looking down this way, there's also your dishwasher there, and if we take this other view looking back out into the main room, you can see your sink and this nice layout with the fire roaring in the background. Finally, this is just another shot trying to demonstrate how tall the ceilings are. For this last area in the main room, you have your dining table, which is a high top table with four black stools around it. Along this wall, you also have a bit of a bar setup. It includes a bunch of cocktail making supplies and glasses if you'd like to drink during your stay. If you look to the right of the kitchen, there's a hallway which eventually leads to the master bedroom. So we're gonna head down this way now. There are two doors. We'll quickly pop into the door on the left, and this contains your washer and dryer and some extra storage space for the owner. If we continue down the same hall, we'll now enter into the master bedroom. It has a similar color scheme to that first bedroom we saw with the black and white. It is a bit New York theme though, with an image of the Flatiron Building there on the right, and the opposite wall contains a large closet that you can store your luggage in. In this corner, you have this classy looking black dresser and another one of those circular mirrors. There's also an additional chair all next to the entrance door that we walked in through. Over here now, you have your in-suite bathroom. Over there on the right side, you have a simple glass shower, and on the left is your sink setup. You can also walk on through, and there is a door, of course, for privacy, but you can find your toilet there on the left-hand side. Thanks for watching, guys, and I'll see you soon for another Airbnb tour.